There are a lot of women who would love to be with a man who has money, and I think everybody knows that. There are a lot of men and women, but mostly men, who discuss these types of women and have very harsh words for them. So I thought maybe today, from a woman's point of view, we could delve into why some women find money so important. Are they just gold diggers, or is there another smart reason that women are attracted to that? Hello everyone, my name is Jennifer Molesky and this is my YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about money, money, men and money, and women and why they like it. So let's just do it. What is money and how do you get it? This is not a trick question, okay? So I'll answer. This is all my thoughts. Money, yeah, is a representation of effort and ability. Money is our globally accepted practice of converting energy, your energy, into a fiat tool that helps you get what you want and need in life. It's just the final result of a mathematical conversion, reduction. Women are converters too. Remember, they convert masculine attributes into sexual attraction. Watch the video here when you're done with this video. So money requires your energy in order to obtain it. Money likes to be seduced. She's a temptress and she's a trickster. Money wants your energy, and if you're good, she'll reward you with her presence. And if you're really good, she'll reward you with an abundance of her presence. If you're flirty with her, you'll come to understand that she comes around way easier when you perform an action that is needed and wanted by society. She really likes people who give hope and help to mankind. And if you're not yet good at attracting money, no problem. There's a ton of financial pickup artists who will coach you on how to get good at financial seduction. They'll teach you all sorts of ways. And if you get really good at it, you'll rarely lose. But there's no guarantee. Markets are volatile. It might be easier to make gains, and it might be far more fair if there weren't so many unfair laws and government intervention protecting a select group of the population. But when you get good at making money, you'll start to understand the difference between a good investment and one that looks good to the population but is actually very dangerous. These dangerous, look good types of ways to make money are what burns people, and that's what keeps people out of trying to get back into the wealth game. But this all gets straightened out in the wash when you learn about money and how to attract it. And when you actually get good at making money, you'll see that even if you're financially ruined, which no one wants, but if you get financially ruined, it doesn't really matter, because you're so good at seducing money, you'll always get more. Nothing can keep you down. So if you want to learn how to succeed in financial seduction, don't listen to gurus who tell you how they lost all their money and never recovered because of ridiculous laws or plummeting stocks or unfair taxation or untrustworthy business partners. They have lost and will try to tell you that you shouldn't try because you'll lose too. My advice to you is listen to winners. Okay, so getting back to obtaining money through effort and ability. Sometimes the task required, the task that you do to earn money, requires little effort and no special ability, a menial job. So if you happen to be a person who is the performer of said menial job, good chances are that you won't be earning a lot of the magic seductress known as fiat currency and wealth. Why not? Because most people, no matter the looks or intelligence, can perform the task. It's not very special. Because, or so, when many, most, or all of a population can do something, the demand for the performers is met, and there's also a surplus of people left over who could do said task. Even if all the menial performers just got up and quit and walked away, replacing them wouldn't be difficult. And I used an important word there, and I did it on purpose. Do you know which word it is? It's replace. Lower wage jobs are filled with replaceable employees. And that's not an easy thing to hear, especially when you are a person who is in that menial position, but it's pretty true. The key to getting out of that is a person's desire to obtain more. That motivates them up and forward. It is the man who is dedicated to testing his ability and endurance, his want to be in a more comfortable position. That is the motivation required to rise up and out of a low wage position. Time, effort, grit, tenacity, money. there's a lot of subconscious calculations going on underneath a woman's reason for letting money weigh so heavily on the decision of who she wants to be with. A man's income can assist a woman in deciding if he will make a good husband and father, and if finding a provider is important to her, if she wants to stay home with the children perhaps, money will weigh even heavier on her decision. Many men think that a woman who wants a man who makes money is spoiled or just wants to use that man for his money. Perhaps if you're with a shiner, probably. She needs your money to keep shining up so she can be attractive to the world. But if you're looking for a woman who would make a good wife, you're going to want a woman who makes wise decisions. Decisions that would benefit her, and more importantly, be of benefit to her to-be family. If her husband is not a man who the world at large considers replaceable, that's a good start to finding a husband who is not replaceable. Women don't want to be with a replaceable man. Replaceable can result in financial struggle, and most women want to avoid that. You want to avoid that. It's pretty normal. So what is clear to me is that what I'm saying would make young man despondent, because rare is the young person who has figured out how to earn good money, and more rare than that is the person who has actually done it. It's not surprising to me that some young men would take issue with this. When you're young and horny and you want a beautiful woman who is eager to please you and only you, her desire for you to have a healthy income can seem unfair. It can seem like a woman should care about you, like what's on the inside. Your mom knows how special you are. Why can't a sweet, pretty girl see that too? And I actually really feel bad for you if you are a young person now, because chances are you were raised where you were not taught that there is differentiation and achievement, and you can earn a higher status. You've probably been taught that everyone gets the trophy, but that's not how life works. I hate to be the welcomer to this cruel, unjust world, but welcome to the real world. So what is surprising to me, and it should be to you as well, is the amount of older men who are fueling the anger of young men. Some of these men become very wealthy themselves, getting young men to focus their energy on what? Themselves? No, on women, but avoiding them and hating them. I can't understand this. They get these men to think and focus on women instead of focusing their energy on becoming as successful as these young men actually want to be. Old men who have failed are telling other men that they'll fail too. It's the same thing that I just said about the investor. You wouldn't find an investor who's like, dude, I used to have some money, like some of it, and then I lost it. And dude, if you even try to make money, you're just stupid, you're gonna lose it. Who would do that, okay? I just want people to be honest with themselves about what they really want and to listen to people who want to help them achieve it. Don't want you to listen to people who help you to lie to yourself and who funnel your precious, precious energy into hate and retaliation. Money. Let's talk about money. Number one, in order to make it and rise up, you must give. Give of yourself. You are able to give time to what's important. If you want money, you can't spend your free time drinking or playing video games or trying to bang a lot of women, because it takes energy. Especially when you don't have money, it takes a lot of energy. Watching TV or doing other things that sound like a good time. If you're going after money in a serious way, you can't do that. You have to give yourself to the cause, and you have to spend your precious time doing so. Number two, you have to have a plan to obtain the money, and then you have to take every tedious step to actualize that plan. Strategize. Number three, you have to be the kind of person who doesn't give up once you've decided that you're gonna do something. You have grit. Number four, you have to do specific things to become valuable. Either your mind is your value, or it's a gift that you have, an idea that you need to make into a reality, an invention, a tactic. Whatever it is, you have to hone in and find a way to make sure that that value is used by society, used as often as possible by the highest bidder, or used as often as possible to the masses, or even to few people who are willing to spend the most amount of money for that valuable thing that you have. Number five, that means you have to become good with people, but you don't like people, right? This is a whole generation of, oh man, I just can't stand people. They're just like, ugh. So when you say that you can't stand people, either you suck at being with people, or you think you're better than people. You suck at being with people, or you're better than them. No successful person acts that out. You have to have other people around you in order to be successful. What I'm saying to you don't have to like people, but you can't let that show. And you don't have to like them, but you have to learn how to read people, to sell to them, to know what their needs are so you can meet their needs. You have to be able to interact with people and not act like they're a burden to you. You're not gonna make money that way. Number six, you have to surround yourself with a certain type of group of people. You can't hang out with people who spend their time fixing old cars if you wanna be the forerunner in plastic surgery due to a new procedure that you're mastering. It doesn't make sense. You have to know who can help you to succeed and how you will be valuable to them, and you have to present and sell yourself to them and be welcomed in by that group. You have to be a benefit to them, they'll be a benefit to you. This is really important. Number seven, to obtain all of that, you have to be picky about everything, about what you're going after, about what you're doing, how you spend your time, where your intent is. If you want to be successful, you have to go after the best and not settle. You have to be picky. You've already, if you decided you're going to be successful, you are already successful in your mind, and you cannot act in a way that betrays that mindset. Now that we have listed some of what it takes to be financially successful, let's break all that down in a way that will help you to understand that kind of man through the eyes of a woman. If you manage to pull all that off, you will earn money. And by mastering all those things, you become, in the process, a catch to most women. Here's how. I'm going to use the word you when I'm referring to the man that has obtained this, okay? Number one, she sees you as a man who has given of himself to what he has deemed as important. Now she wants you to think that she's important so that you will give to her. To get that for most women would be an honor. Number two, she sees that you use your time wisely for that which is important. She assumes that you would manage your time with her and the family well. That's very attractive. It's a really important trait. Simple, important. Number three, because she sees that you can plan and strategize to get what you want and that your plan bears fruit, she'll assume that you want a happy family and that you would create an effective lifelong plan to make sure that your family is happy and strong. She'll do everything she can to make herself a part of that plan. If you pick her because she can trust you, she knows her life will be smooth because she can trust you. Number four, you don't give up easily, and that makes her feel secure about her future with you. No one wants a quitter, and you have proved that you're not a quitter. It's important. Number five, because you've done the things it takes to create value, and she appreciates the work that takes, she has respect for you. Something she desperately wants is to find a man that she deeply respects. You have become that sort of man all while you were getting what you wanted anyway. Two birds, one stone. This is good advice. Number six, your friends are most likely successful and important, and that's admirable. And because they have welcomed you, remember, you did all the things it takes to be welcomed, because they finally welcomed you into their group, she has social proof that you are also successful and important. You have been vetted, and you've been vetted by picky, valuable, smart people. Number seven, you're picky. This might be the most important one. If a picky man, in this case you, chooses her, that is validation of who she is. It's evidence to the outside world, her family, her friends, her neighbors, to herself, that she is okay, that she made all the right decisions, that she has cultivated all the right things. And the evidence is you. You are the evidence. You're very important to her. Money can provide security for herself and the family, and that's important. And you, a successful picky person, picked her. That's validation. When a woman has safety, protection, and validation, she can go her whole life respecting and loving and honoring that man. For sure, there are gold diggers out there. There's certainly women who want to use and abuse men for their money. But there's also very logical, wise reasons for that preference. If you choose shiny bitches who just want the attention and the luster and the fame, you have not been taught what's important, just like those women haven't, okay? So the next video I'm gonna do, because I'm gonna do one, because I'm back, baby. I'm gonna start making these YouTube videos again. My next video is gonna be the other things besides money that are very important to a woman. Because maybe you're the kind of guy that's like, you know what, money's just not for me. It's not important to me, it's never been important to me. I don't wanna spend my energy trying to gain that. I get it, I respect it. Even I respect it. There are other things that in the list that I'm sure you'll be like, oh dude, that's me. I can cultivate that. And there are women that are attracted to that. Good women. Okay? So what do you think? Am I right? Am I wrong? Do you hate what I said but you think I'm right? Do you love what I said but you think I'm wrong? That's it. I can't wait to read your comment. I know it's gonna be really constructive. If only, right? Okay, everyone, be well. I'll see you soon. Beep.